Maryland Boost Program, you've heard me grouse about it quite a bit for the past month or so, and Dan as well. Building opportunities for students today.
Is that right?
Building and opening opportunities, yeah, or something
it.
For today.
A boost.
Right, yeah. So this is the basically the school choice program, mm-hmm, that Maryland has, and it's paltry. It's $10 million. Drop in the bucket when it comes to money being spent in the General Assembly. But yet, there's been a lot of bickering over $2 million. Governor Moore really started off things with a bang, saying, I'm immediately cutting $2 million from this program that's mostly benefiting low-income students in Baltimore City. And we're going to cut this money because, you know, we have our own suspicions as to why you do that. But he says public money is for public dollars. The Senate came back and said, no, we're not doing that. Senator Ferguson's like, I like this program. We're going to continue doing it. So they add the $10 million back, or add the $2 million back, so it was back to $10 million. I thought it was over, and then yesterday, next thing I know, there's apparently some big kerfuffle over whether the House is going to dig their heels in. And so today there was a big meeting to discuss what was going to come of that. And got an email from my good friends with the Maryland House Republican Caucus saying that they had good news for us. Joining us to discuss that good news is Maryland State Senator Steve Hershey. He is the minority leader, so the leader of the Republicans in the Maryland Senate. Senator Hershey, thanks so much for joining the program. Can you give us a brief rundown? What happened today?
Sure. Good afternoon, guys. We do have some good news, finally. You know, as you know, the budget process, the bill gets passed through both the Senate and the House, and then any differences in the two pieces of legislation are settled out in what's called a conference committee. So today, the conference committees met, and they came to an agreement that would put $9 million total into the Boost program. So it's $1 million less than what we had before, but $1 million more than what we had from the governor's budget. And then $2.5 million that could be used for non-public schools in the areas of nurses, safety, books, and things of that nature. And that was an increase from $1 million that we had previously. So altogether, we've got $11.5 million that can be used for the Boost program and these non-public schools. And another big plus that we had was that there was language in there previously that said that the Boost program could only be used by siblings of students that are already in the program. We were able to get that language removed, and so that in a sense opens this up to more students to have these type of opportunities.
Senator, how instrumental was Wes Moore in this entire conversation? How hard was he pushing to make these cuts? Because we've been talking about the governor, and he seems to be missing in action on a whole host of issues. Was he the one who was guiding Democrats who were trying to strip this bill of money?
You know, listen, I heard your preview to this, and you never know why people vote a certain way or the types of policies that they move forward. But listen, you know, I'm sure that there are a lot of people that are down here in Annapolis that feel that the teachers union helped them get through a Democratic primary. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, down here, when the teachers union asked these legislators to jump, they just simply respond by saying how high. And this is, I think, one of those things where there certainly was some type of, I hate to say payback because it's not necessarily financially, but there was something that says that the teachers union has just despised this Boost program, and they can't stand the fact that there's any type of public money going towards these non-public schools. And so they call on their legislators and people down here in Annapolis to do the work that they want them to do. And it was very unfortunate to see the governor's first budget come out with a cut to this very important program. But again, I'm happy that at the end of the day, the legislators prevailed and we got the funding in the program.
We're speaking with Maryland State Senator Steve Hershey. He's out of District 36, Republican. That represents Caroline, Cecil, Kent, and Queen Anne's County. You probably got the opportunity to hear testimony from people who benefited from this program. Can you tell our listeners a bit about what you heard that made you and the Republican caucus so aggressive in fighting for this program?
Yeah, well, certainly, first of all, I mean, school choice is very important to us. And I think what's very important as well is to understand that all children learn differently. and different types of environments are better for different students. And this was one of the things, you know, non-public schools have certainly been open to a number of people to put their students in, but generally it had to be something that you could afford to do. And what Boost was put in place to do is help those that cannot afford it to have some type of financial scholarships or assistance to bring those types of students into these non-public schools. And what we're seeing is that there's very, very positive results. Achievement is up when it comes to these types of students in these non-public schools. And we heard a lot of parents come in and even brought some of the students in and say how positive an opportunity and relationship that these kids had in their classrooms. They were learning, and you know, those types of things were very important as we continue to make it a priority of our caucus.
Senator, just one last question before we let you go on an unrelated item. Do you have any knowledge about where the Ivan Bates gun bill is currently, the gun sentencing bill is currently in the assembly? Are we ever going to hear about this again, or is it dead?
Well, you know, we were hoping that we were going to hear something this week on it. In fact, I was on the with C4 and Brian early this week, and just after Chairman Smith was on, and thought that we might see something at some time this week. We didn't see that. I know for a fact I was just came out of a finance committee, and JPR was still in their committee. You know, I'm hoping we see something. And you know, that's going to be our next thing that we do after we've gotten through with this positive result for Boost. We're gonna say our next priority was crime and you know, trying to get safer communities. We haven't seen anything that has given us any indication that they want to see safer communities. That's a very big concern. And I think we're going to continue. Well, I know we're going to continue to push to get something out. We thought that the legislation that Ivan Bates brought forward to us is something that is at least a middle ground, that you do have stiffer penalties for those that commit these types of crime. Even if that's used as a means of plea bargaining down to something else, you've got to start with something that, you know, puts some type of consequences on the actions that that people are taking when committing crimes.
Senator Steve Hershey, thank you so much for taking time out of your busy afternoon to join us. Best of luck as you guys. How much time is left in the session?
We've got, next Monday, not this Monday, but the following Monday is sine die.
All right. Well,
a little bit more than a week.
Hang in there, Senator. We're rooting
thank
for you.
Thank you very much.
Take care.
Yeah, and guys, thank you so much for bringing these issues out to your listeners. It's very important for
absolutely
us as well.
No problem.
All right.
Take care. That was Maryland State Senator Steve Hershey, the minority leader. And, I mean, look, the Republicans are doing the best that they can, but, I mean.
They are. And look, kudos to them for fighting.
Yeah,
you know, they 100%. Would be very, very easy in this environment to roll over and let the Democrats just do whatever they want. They obviously are organized enough to put up a fight.
Absolutely.